Hi everyone, and welcome to Penny for a Tale. Tonight we are running Relics, a Game of Angels by 10 Star Games, written by Steve D. See the amazing book right here. It is now available on 10 Star's website, as well as our Drive-Through RPG and Indie Game Revolution. So you could go ahead and pick it up there. They also have their amazing tarot deck, which I forgot last time. Also, just before we kind of get into tonight's session, we're going to go ahead and reintroduce our cast, who can go ahead and give their intros.
Hey, everybody. My name is Philip. I hail from Texas. I am actually going to be playing Eamon, who is underneath me right here. Eamon is an angel who thinks that individuals should be, all humanity should be led from the front. And so, and he's the guy to do it. He's a motivational speaker. He's got wonderful, wonderful wit, wonderful charm. May not always think about all the repercussions, but that's okay, because you know what? I've got all the answers, and if everybody just followed behind me, everything would be fine. So stay tuned to learn more about how you can be a part of history.
Bill just described himself, by the way.
Whoa, okay, listen, that's too strong. It's too strong.
Anyway, hi everyone. My name is Rowena. I hail from Maryland, and I am playing Koi Boomba. As you can see, Koi's claim to fame is creating the leopard. And so with that, Koi really believes in physicality and athleticism. Koi loves jogging and exercising, so there'll be a lot of that happening. If you haven't seen the other episodes, you'll get a great workout with Koi today. And yeah, I'm not going to have a ridiculous, you know, segue like my friend here, but that's Koi.
Hi, I'm Ashley, and I am as well from Maryland, and this evening I will be playing Ironheart. He is a sword-wielding warrior who looks forward to nothing more than to kill the demons that have entered this world.
I am Paul. I am from Rochester, Minnesota, and I am going to be playing the professor, Amina. She is a professor of anthropology, history, and comparative religions. She believes strongly in helping humanity to write down their history. And she also has a very strong passion for humans to have choice. And because of that, she was one of the founders of the first human democracy, leading humanity to go that direction, to allow for more choice. So,
hi, I'm Danny. I'm from San Diego, and I'll be playing One-Eyed Jack, an angel who really appreciates that luck works here in Earth, unlike heaven, where things are incredibly boring. He spends his time mostly in Vegas, which he built, playing poker, which he designed, and donates a whole bunch of money he takes from bad people to good causes.
And my name is Eric. I will be playing Yuri, the hacker angel of the internet, whose main interest isn't in anything to do with demons or forces like that. It's more about dealing with the core wound that's been left in all angels by mom leaving us behind and locking us out. We are the ultimate latchkey kids and orphans. So my focus is really on getting people to deal with that.
Basically, this entire session is going to be a big, you know, therapy session with Yuri, and it will be amazing. Real quick, I am the GM Sam. For this game, it's the dealer. You can catch me also on Star Wars on Monday nights and Static Dawn as a player, not a GM, but it's all amazing stuff. Real quick, this game uses the Creative Commons license of the Fugue system, which is a game mechanic by James Wallace. Relics uses it as well. And yeah, we're just going to go ahead and hop right in. I'll kind of give a quick recap for anyone just tuning in on what's been going on, as well as a little bit about kind of relics in general. So far in our story, we've had our group of angels go into this random inferno casino, make their way up to the top floor, trying to figure out how to use an elevator, and basically let a demon escape for some reason. I don't know why Ironheart did that, but you know, the world is a confusing and weird place. From there, we spent a very long time discussing things at Denny's, where, you know, where all deep philosophical thoughts sort of happen, you know, and you're really stretched to your limit there over those pancakes and whipped cream. And then sadly, Amon's secretary, maybe more, got captured by the FBI, and now we're out in the desert with a crazy cult trapped inside of a dark temple, you know?
And just it's your, kind of your typical trip. Your typical weekend.
Typical. Yeah, Vegas. You know, typical weekend in Vegas. You know, so what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. We don't know. It's gonna be
I
great.
Think we're in Utah now, so maybe it won't stay
in
Utah.
We are in Utah, you know? Weird things happen in Utah. We're kind of in that weird desert place. But just real quick, just a little bit about relics. Angels are definitely not your typical kind of cherub with wings and cuteness. No, they're this sort of 8-foot tall behemoth things with like multiple eyes and four wings. Like definitely not like, they're actually what people usually think demons look like in some ways. So yeah, it's just all propaganda by the angels, you know. And it's kind of the same with angel morality, you know, you're supposed to protect humans and the rest of creation and try to blend in, but then that kind of inherently contradicts the others. So the way angels interpret it is very interesting. But anyways, you guys will see that in gameplay. So we're just going to go ahead and kind of set the scene for kind of what's going on. When we left, you guys were in this darkened chapel. A demon was in front of you. Yuri had just stopped the individual with the nail gun from continuing to shoot at you guys with his technology stare. It's we don't exactly know what Yuri does. He stares at things and they stop working. We don't know. But basically Dantillion sort of, he stands up and the last thing he said to the group was, Amina, it's been a while. So real quick, Amina, what are you feeling right now as you see this individual?
This is a big emotion. This is all of Amina's probably nightmares that have ever plagued her for the past thousands of years coming true again, coming face to face with Dantillion once more. But at the same time, I think that Amina feels like this is also the time that things are going to be put to right.
Yeah.
So she has whether it's a false or not, she has a confidence as she faces off and kind of takes a step towards him and says something along the lines of, well, I would say that it's good to see you, but we both know that's not true.
I mean, in the background, as if it is good to see him.
Amina, is this a breakup thing? Did you date him? Is that what this is all about?
Amina doesn't look away from Dantillion at all. She stands facing him full on and just says back to you, this is the murderer that I told you about. And it's our job to make sure that he does not cause that kind of destruction again.
At this point, Ironheart will actually step between the group and the demon and say, then he shall die.
Okay, Ironheart, your face is on fire. You can hardly stand the pain that you are feeling right now. And it kind of takes everything to not, you know, back away. But also going over to Koi, you know, when Jack mentioned, did you date him or something? You kind of have this memory come back to you about when you first fell to humanity, because you know you play this sort of face, but you are the first one out of this whole group to fall. You are the oldest one here, despite the appearances that you sort of have led everyone to believe. But what are you thinking when you see Dantillion?
Oh, I want to run up to him and slash his throat. I am so ready to just let's just finish this. He's the one that caused all of this, and he needs to pay.
Yeah, but do you remember how he got to you?
Oh man, well, you know, I was the first to fall, and when humanity was first established, it was nothing like what it is today. Everyone was in harmony. Everyone looked out for each other. It was like a beautiful, it was like a pride of leopards, just, you know, we're all just helping each other out and being kind to each other and sharing, you know, food and resources. And when he showed up, he put these ideas into their heads that this was not the right way, that the only way to survive and the only way to thrive is to backstab and to go behind and to go and you know, kill each other in warfare. And he poisoned them, essentially. He told them that the way to salvation is to go against mom's wishes. And I don't know if that has anything to do with why she kicked us out.
And if you remember, he also told you that he loved you, Koi, and you believed Dantillion at first, and that's how he was able to get such a stronghold in the society.
I don't want to think about that. I don't want to think about that, because that vulnerability, that opening myself up, is what led to all of this. It's because of me that this all happened. And so that's not the way it should have played out. I should have never heard those words, because they were not the truth at all. It was lies. Yeah.
Probably time to start running some laps.
Oh yeah. You best believe.
Stuff. Yeah. You know, there's sort of a bunch of mixed emotions going on right now, but Amina, you've definitely stepped forward, and doing so, you know, it's been 1500 BC since you've seen Dantillion, you know, but he looks the same as when, you know, you saw the volcano, you know, just utterly rip the island of Akurati to pieces, you know. And everyone that you had loved, everyone that you had, you know, been working with at that point, you know, was buried beneath this 4 mile wide caldera, 200 feet of ash and debris, you know, and just to top it all off, left that island abandoned for centuries, you know, and they finally started pulling up the pieces of that society back, you know, because you were there during that excavation in 1967, you know, back in 2008 when they finally started unearthing, you know, the actual houses that you had stayed in, like you were there. And yeah, it's just, he's standing there just looking so cocky and smiling at you guys. Like, welcome my siblings, or I guess the humans say my brothers and sisters, or, you know, whatever you are right now.
It's good to see you again.
And we get to the monologuing that you desperately want to do, Dantillion, because I know you're proud of whatever it is this all is, so please share with the class. I call.
Jack, why don't you share what you're thinking about? I am just happy to have you guys here with me again.
Why are we talking to him again? Shouldn't we just kill him? That's our goal, right?
Maybe. I want to know if the thing in Vegas was his responsibility and why, because I don't understand it and it has me curious. And if we just kill him, he won't be able to tell us.
Dealer, do I get the impression that we are extremely overpowered in this room?
You definitely can hardly look at him with the pain that you are feeling.
Okay. And if Ironheart looks backwards, what is the girl doing?
She,
the cult leader.
Yeah.
The cult leader. You know, you've seen her kind of try and pull the trigger a couple more times on the Nalgene, but whatever Yuri had done to it, it doesn't seem to be working anymore. So she's kind of cast that to the side, but, you know, after Dantillion started speaking, she just kind of gets this odd look on her face as she looks up at him, definitely seeing something different than all of you see. This amazing creature speaks.
Okay.
But yeah, how are you feeling, Ironheart, besides in pain?
Feeling like I want to run forward and kill this thing. He is going to actually cause his sword to basically start to radiate fire. And he will go to strike him.
Yeah. Why don't you go ahead, pull a card.
Okay.
For this, you are blighted because you are in intense pain.
Okay. So lower of two.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So my lower of two is the three of swords. However, that is my suit.
It is true. And you are striking.
And I would be using divine, what is it called? Immolation on this as well.
Excellent. Yeah, so you guys see Ironheart charging forward as he does. Why don't you go ahead and describe this real quick?
So I would raise my sword up. As the flames trail behind the sword, I have become very impatient. And I run forward, bringing my sword down across, or aiming at least to bring my sword down across his body, hoping to at least knock him back, to give my siblings a chance to realize that it's a demon. It deserves to die.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm pulling cards as well. He steps into your blade, it seems like, and you feel your sword go across his chest. You feel that flesh give. Just sort of chuckles at you. Go ahead and pull one more card for me.
Okay. Another sword, and I believe it's the four. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong. I am not as good with Roman numerals.
Yep,
it's four.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Perfect. And you could kind of feel like you were, some force was about to shove you back, but you're able to sort of take a step to steady yourself. But the wound that you feel like you would have dealt him isn't there.
Okay.
Not a good thing.
No, not a good thing.
First of all, how did you run so fast?
Yes. Tell me your secret.
Second of all, that's not going to work. That's not going to work.
Not very either.
He will sidestep back a little and then go, then what will? We shall kill him today.
Talking.
Yuri, you've always been a good talker, haven't you?
I seem to do it when I have to. I'm not as skilled at it as Amonset, but I just try to say what needs to be said.
You know, I'm glad you said that, because let me talk more about myself. It's important that everybody understands how great I am. Just kidding.
Perhaps you could explain that to Dantillion.
No, I don't want to do that, because currently I'm like at the back, with some sort of mixed emotions of both injustice and like bewilderment and pure anger. So it's like a tension that is almost holding me captive. In addition that, like, Cassie next to me, I don't want anything bad to happen to her. But at the same time, I feel this need to be kind of fixing this situation, you know, and talking about the, and working through it. So, I mean, Yuri, as you typically do, have touched upon a singe point or a for me. So I would like to be talking, but I don't really know what the best action is.
But you have more concerns right now.
I do.
I think so. Amina is going to speak up and just say, Ironheart, let's stop fooling around with him. If we need to talk, then let's talk, but this needs to be settled here and now.
I agree.
I'm tired of watching the ways that you have torn apart the history of this world with all of the evil and horrible things that you have done. So for all of those that you have caused to turn away from good, to die in the fires, for Lysagoras, let's finish this.
Amina, I don't know what you're talking about. It was a volcano, love. Can't predict those things. Humans like to kill. They revel in the bloodshed.
No, they don't. You caused it. It wasn't always that way. You know it.
I wasn't tasked with that. I wasn't paying attention to humans until later, much, much later.
Amina just kind of snarls at him with that sort of grandmotherly, you know you're lying.
Is it my fault, Amina? I mean, just as much as it was Koi Boomba's fault, couldn't you have saved those people? Couldn't you have asked for Mother's divine power to come and save them?
You manipulated me.
You seem to enjoy it.
I am not giving you the satisfaction of my enjoyment, okay? Let's settle this, as Amina said.
So what does settling it mean?
He almost seems to be patient as he listens to you guys, just sort of standing there, letting you guys each say your piece again, just sort of, it seems like he has all the time in the world for this.
Did you bring us here for therapy? Is that what this is?
If so, he could have just come to Denny's.
Oh, poor Danny needs a hug. I'm going to walk up and give him a hug with the landmine between us.
I forgot you had a landmine.
Dang, going all kamikaze.
All right. What is your plan for this landmine? Is the pressure being pushed against Dantillion in yourself?
Yes. It's in between us, so that as long as we maintain this hug, like standing on the landmine that you heard go click, everything's fine. But if we should back up a little bit.
Excellent. Yeah.
This is why Sam doesn't write anything.
Exactly.
Jack, this is totally your character too, you know? You just...
It's a gamble.
It's true. Dantillion he doesn't stiffen. He also wraps his arms around you, and you know, you kind of feel that light chuckle in his chest as, you know, he's slightly taller than you. Like, Jack. What do the humans say? A banana in your pocket? Or are you just that happy to see me?
Not a banana.
So he's happy to see you.
Well, I mean, I expected it from Koi, but from you as well. Seems sort of wink over at Koi.
So why'd you come to my city? I know you want to brag about it.
Your city?
Vegas.
I'm not in Vegas. I'm clearly here.
That nonsense with the... what were their names? Guys, help me out. I forgot. The casino owner who wanted to eat our hearts, and the demon he had trapped to help him make a fake casino. Who were they? That wasn't you?
I mean, you guys all seem to be blaming me for things. Could have been me.
We followed the trail that led to you, so I'm hoping that means that everything's all nice and rolled up and simple answers, but that's not how Mom works, is it?
Nope.
Jack, you're so young. No. What? How are you, Jack? How are you?
The longer we stand here, the more that answer is tending toward bored.
Yeah. What are you going to do? Are you going to step back? Are you going to kill that human and all your friends? Because you're bored?
Maybe. What do you think?
Maybe. No, but this is definitely an interesting hug. Quite enjoying it.
It's not at all creepy.
Yeah. But Jack, as you, you know, hug him, you're in this kind of close proximity to him, that feeling that someone within your group is going to take something from you, that sort of resentment towards the others grows slightly, you know, not at sort of an alarming rate that you would, you know, think anything of it, but it's been there. It's been there since the Inferno, since, you know, you guys saw that building crumble. Somebody's playing something within you guys. But you just don't know who.
Ironheart would start trying to get his siblings and especially Cassie to back the way from the live mine to ensure at least, you know, some safety.
So we're towards the back, right? So the door is right, is close to us, right? Is there like we would be able to, I might be able to slip Cassie out the back and fly her to safety.
Yeah, if you want to leave Jack and Dantillion and everyone behind for your human.
Well, I think I can because I can fly at hundreds of miles per hour. And so if I were to carry, if I was to carry
you
Cassie,
can.
I can.
You can.
I don't think Cassie can.
But I can carry her.
You can carry parts of her.
Don't worry. If I'm flying, I've got what they call, is it a blessing or I've got a.
Inertial dampeners?
I've got inertial dampeners, yes.
Cassie's last name's not Stacy, is it?
No. but I'll definitely yell engage right before I, you know, jump into the air. So I'm gonna try and slip out while they're monologuing and we've got an explosive hug going on up front.
Literally.
I'm gonna try to slip out to see if I can get Cassie back to safety or at least somewhere out in the middle of nowhere, somewhere.
Yeah. What about that other human that was trying to
Oh, I don't care. Oh, about her?
Yeah, why don't you all draw a card, because where is she?
Oh, interesting. I got death.
So sore.
Five of coins.
I have Damabie, the world.
Mm. Eight of swords.
I want your card. Okay, I digress.
This is what you get for running without, you know.
Without honoring the Boomba.
Practicing. Didn't train.
So this is interesting.
Train for your run.
We have death and the world in play.
Yeah.
Fountain of wisdom. Success to all ventures.
Yeah. For So Cassie's alive.
Cassie's great. Cassie is great. She's good.
The rest of us?
Well, we might be in trouble. What happens first before you get too comfortable, Ammon? Ironheart and Ammon both draw a card for me.
I got the Knight of Stubs.
Okay. What you got for us, Ammon?
Oh, for me?
Mm-hmm.
The Queen of Pentacles.
All right, you get to act first, luckily. Go ahead and describe this, because you have a dramatic success just short of a miracle right now.
Oh, perfect. So my sole goal is to get Cassie out of here, because I have realized this, and this is a really interesting thing that I don't know if I've ever realized before. Because I'm so invested in Cassie, I am useless to our group in this situation.
You just realized that?
Yes. Yes. Just realized
it. You realized it.
And that, thank you, Yuri. I appreciate that. You're always asking those weird questions. And this time, maybe something prodded me at Denny's to realize, you know, who knows? But I both simultaneously care so much, but am I too invested? Am I so invested that I am? Listen, nobody was asking you, Coy, okay?
Don't invest in any caring or any intimacy. I'm just
caring
saying.
Caring is the only reason why we're here. Why would we even come down to this planet if we weren't going to help people?
Caring is the reason why Dantillion is here, too.
Is that the reason why you cared for Dantillion?
Oh,
I won't talk about it. I'm going to
This
go
is
for
a run. Telepathic conversation that's going on. Yeah. By the way, that's happening. So, I mean, that's a really interesting thing. So my goal in this situation now is I have to get her out of there, because I am totally ineffective with her being here. So even though it may cause some trouble while I'm leaving and taking her to wherever, like, I have to do that. So I think that this is like, you know, while we have, you know, monologuing going on and, you know, hugs happening, I don't know what's going on over there. I think I'll take this moment to just slowly slip out the front door and grab Cassie's hand probably behind my back and just pull her, you know, out the door with me.
Definitely willingly follows you.
Naturally, of course she does. And so
she just also wants to get out of there since there's a mine.
A mine slash like seven supernatural beings, one of which hell-bent on destruction. I mean, you know, just typical stuff. Again, Vegas, Saturday night. So at this point, I don't know how the Nesher flight works. If it's kind of like a superhero type, you know, pose, and then you know, leap straight into the
however
air.
However you want it to be.
It's just kind of, okay.
Oh, boy.
It's kind of like, I mean, it's definitely, this is a Superman Lois Lane situation. and I mean, just as romantic as that can possibly be, just, you know, kind of take off and start flying in the direction of the aircraft that we came in on. So thinking that if I can just get her back there, at least she'll be, you know, somewhat safe, you know, as a home base.
Yeah. Normally this would have killed a human, the speed at which you are flying, but it's just a miracle that she is able to survive this, you know, a little surprised and bewildered, definitely windswept, but slightly unstable on her feet as you put her down, but you are able to make it back to that that airport, that small private airport that you guys had landed at in St. George.
So this is definitely, she's got the 1980s
frazzled
hair, wind sweat, kind of like, you know, she stuck her finger in an electrical socket type thing. And it's
basically wide-eyed.
It's what love feels like, baby. Just saying.
Yeah, she can't even form words, but she just kind of like points in the direction that you had just flown from and just kind of shakes her hands as she like stumbles towards the plane.
I would say to her, you know, as we kind of come in for a landing, you know, definitely Peter Pan style, I still have some surprises. No words.
Yeah. But she, you know, she gets partway to the plane and you haven't taken off yet. And she pauses and turns around and looks at you. You'll come back, right?
And then I would look at her, not knowing, but believing, of course believing, but not knowing. Giving her that solid wink that, you know, I always do. And then, you know, straight up in the air.
Right. Perfect. Hopefully that wasn't your last meeting, but...
What?
All right, going back to our amazing explosive.
This landmine better end its situation before I get back, just saying.
Yeah, all right, Ironheart. You are just overcome with the pain that is in your face, you know. You are sort of like a cornered leopard right now. You know, you have, you're trapped, your foot is trapped in a trap. And you're just sort of backed into this corner, and the only thing you can think to do is just swing your sword.
Okay.
Everything that is moving, you know. You have no clue what's going on with Yuri, but he seems like he's probably turning into a demon. Might as well go for him. Koi loved a demon. Yeah, go ahead.
So he definitely sees Dentillion as the greatest threat in this room. His siblings, he can deal with them after the fact.
You have to deal with everything now.
He will bring up his sword and use Sword of Majesty. And as he does this, his sword extends in flames. It becomes solid fire, and it burns at a temperature that even coming near it draws destruction to it. It cuts through pretty much anything at this point. He will raise his sword and bring it down upon Dentillion and through the mine.
Y'all should run.
So
can run.
Let me describe this real quick, that you are just bringing your sword down through Jack as well, since he is in front of Dantillion between this mine, because you are bringing it down.
He would bring it from behind Dantillion. He would not necessarily strike directly at his brother, but if Jack gets in the way, you know, oh, Jack I really is in the way. Troll.
The and you drew death. Iron.
Yes.
Not gonna get at this unscathed.
Yes, I no. did.
No.
But yes, he brings his sword down hard. His goal is to kill the demon, to make sure that its evil cannot spread across Mother's creation any longer.
Yeah, so let's do this first. As your sword generates an amazing amount of heat. Yes.
Yeah. So it says 2000 degrees.
Yes. So everything around you, you know, just sort of has the moisture just pulled out of it from this, you know, heat source. And, you know, the entire building has just all of a sudden instantly gone up in flames. So you have, you know, the pillars and stuff, everything is just burning. And then you bring your sword down on Dantillion as well as on Jack. The moment your sword reaches that landmine, it just instantly, it goes off, explosion. So you don't even know how hard you hit them. You don't know how much you just hurt Jack, but there is just this explosion that just is going to level the building. So everyone draw a card that is in the building right now.
Oh, boy, I'm glad I got Cassia out there.
Ace of Cups.
All right.
I got the Six of Wands.
Okay.
I also got the Six of Wands.
Perfect. Jack, you are blighted.
So. I got the Fool. Bladed, so you want another one? Seven of Wands. And Wands is staves, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Because that is my suit.
Yes, Yuri drew their signifier.
Of course.
You drew your signifier?
Of course you drew your signifier.
Eric, I like your set there. That's pretty awesome.
Thanks.
Oh, man. All right. So...
it's the Mystic Mondays tarot set.
Nice. Oh, I saw that on Amazon. I almost got that.
We were playing Amina, on Mondays. What did you pull? I thought it was appropriate.
Wait, what?
Sorry, Sam, go.
No, what did the professor get?
I also got the Six of Wands.
All right.
Which is appropriate. We were standing like next to each other, right?
It is very true. Yeah, but Yuri did get a miracle, correct, Yuri?
Yes,
signifier. Yes. Perfect. All right. So you guys would have taken a lot more damage. So four angels, you guys have 4 points of wounds before you are incapacitated. Each of you take one, except for Jack, who is going to take two.
Jack, you guys has a body of barrel, perfect, which is once per scene. You can ignore any one attack resulting from a failed simple test or several attacks if they all fail on the same round of a complex test. So I'm going to take nothing.
Perfect. Mm. Yes. So, but I want you to describe your miracle, because everyone would have taken 3 things of wounds. But okay, if you want to save them from that, you can, or you can use your miracle for something else.
Hmm. Yuri is the angel of electricity and communication. So I think the explosion still needs to happen, but it needs to stop midway through. So the explosion is going off and everything just freezes. If you cut to the outside of the building, there's no evident impact of this on the outside of the building. The inside's on fire, there's explosion going on, but nothing on the outside of the church. And Yuri is the one to start moving slightly and steps forward before Dantillion or anyone is even hurt and says, I want to know how you're doing. I want to know how you feel about seeing us. I want to know what you've been up to. I want to hear how you feel about seeing Koi again. I want to know if that was something that was real to you or not. I missed you. I know you have issues with Amina, and I'd love it if you could work those out. But that's my desire. I want to know what's going on with you.
Yeah, so and everyone just, around you is frozen, except for you and Dantillion this moment.
Well, I think you can still talk, but the motion is stopped just for a moment. It's like that thing is just frozen just for that heartbeat. And then a lot of stuff can happen in that small heartbeat. And the explosion will not leave the church. It will just be the church is fine. The force will be contained inside of it. So none of the humans will get unnecessarily hurt. Except for the cult leader.
Yeah.
Who killed my fascination with her target of Jed Baron?
She's she's cool. You can kill her.
She's not being protected.
I'm cool with that. It's fine.
You're not here.
Doesn't matter. I'm fine with it. I'm expressing my own personal.
Still talking.
I'm always in my soul.
As a player, I'm fine with it. Kill that woman.
Yeah. So you create this sort of space, and you know all sound stops. Everything is slowly moving in this slow motion, and you can like hear the breath of everyone around you, and you're just able to sort of take it all in as you observe basically everything. And Dantillion looks at you and is not able to lie to you, isn't, you know, this is, you see absolute honesty from him. And he says, I did not mean for Houdini to die. And this is the one human that you cared about and that had been killed. And this is also the reason that you stopped caring for humanity, because the one time you cared, he was killed.
After the analysis became less efficient to care about them as individual and care about them better at groups.
It's true.
I understand that, and I get that we're not in control. This is all Mom. Everything is Mom. Right? So thank you for saying that.
You're interesting, Yuri. I did care for Koi for a time. And I don't know. I just sort of saw that society that Amina had created, and it needed to go. It wasn't time for it. But it's been a long time since I've seen my siblings. Sort of swallows. I don't know what you want, Yuri.
I don't either. I'm still figuring it out.
You can't say these things, Koi. But he blinks and seems to remember himself. You know, we've been around for too long. I've just grown bored.
Oh.
Tired, Yuri.
So you wanted to end it. Okay.
Why not just end it?
That can be allowed. That's what you want. It's too interesting.
That's the way.
It's too fascinating. I mean, what humans are doing in their virtual world is like what we did creating them. It is amazing. As Mom is to us, we are to them, they are to their creations.
You're too easily entertained, Yuri.
I'm fascinated. And I don't think you can end it. Unless Mom wants it to stop, it's not going to stop. Unless Mom wants you to die, you're not going to die. Unless Mom wants you to have a thought, you're not going to have a thought. We were built as tools.
Mom left you here, Yuri. She doesn't care for you.
She did. She doesn't care for me at all. She created me to do a purpose, and she went away.
So why do you?
And I want her back, and I miss her because it's interesting.
She doesn't care about it.
Because it's what I want, and if it's not what I want, it's what she's made me want, and I don't know the difference. But this is something that I feel is real for me, so that's what I do.
Now, if you just let it go and become like me, you can do anything that you want. You don't have to be bound by Mom or these relationships.
I should introduce you to the internet someday. Pretty much everything is on the internet.
Let's get back to this explosion.
All right. So Yuri will take a few steps towards the door and blink and let time restart.
Do you let Dantillion, do you protect him as well or no?
He's asked not to be. He said he wants to end things. So I let him have his desire. And besides, Ironheart got to use their sword. I wouldn't want to take that away from my sibling. I mean, literally, the sword has been the solution for everything. We need a taxi. There's a sword. There's a bill. Get the sword.
Yeah, so as you step back, the explosion happens, and luckily everyone seems to survive. That is important to you, at least, that you've allowed to. Everyone kind of only takes one point of damage besides Jack, who does nothing. Yes, your body. Anyways, and Yuri also takes nothing. Everyone else is one. That human is gone.
What human?
Yeah, what human?
Who cares? On the wall over there.
But, so what happens to the building? Did you contain the explosion to just kind of putter out afterwards and draw in the flames, or?
Yeah, I mean, the inside of the building is wrecked, but outside it's fine. Looking from outside, you wouldn't see any difference.
Yeah, so miraculously, the building is still standing, even though everything is charred and just sort of flattened. And Dantillion is still standing there, no longer hugging Jack, who's kind of had to take a step back, to kind of bring his power. But he looks a little worse for wear, but is still standing. Oh.
So Ironheart will continue the onslaught. It says it lasts per scene, my sword of magistrate. So he will strike at him again. Especially now that Jack is out of the way and he can get a clean shot at him.
Yeah. Is that what you want to go for? Not Koi or the professor? And are you guys going to let him just kill Dantillion before you get your answers? Because Yuri, that conversation was just between you and him, yes?
Oh, no. No, that wasn't just between me. That was meant to be shared between the group. Yeah, this is not a private thing of Yuri only. Yuri wants to share the information. It's important for Koi to hear how this person feels. It's important for Amina to get the admission of what she wants. It's important for Ironheart to be something with the sword.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Ironheart
and
needs
Jack,
to
Jack's
kill.
Gonna be fine.
Jack's Ironheart? Done his one trick, so it's time for him to get out of this burning building. Y'all have fun.
By the way, Yuri, so now once per scene, you are able to stop time.
Nice. And talk to people.
Yes. You are able to move within that.
Hashtag therapy with Yuri. Here we go.
It was great. Yeah, so Amina, Koi, you guys have heard his admission.
I think the Amina has been sort of knocked back, and so she's getting back up to her feet and dusting herself off. Definitely has lost some of the fire that was in her. She's not in a fighting stance anymore, anything like that. And so she maybe takes a step or two forward, still keeping a bit of distance. She looks at Dantillion and says, just answer me this question. Was it all worth it? Are you glad to see so many dead? Do you believe that you've really caused anything worth seeing on the other side?
You care for too much for your humans.
Just answer the question.
I am answering your question. Do you realize how many humans have been born and died in your existence? What was a couple thousand all at once? They gotta go back to your mother, our mother. Didn't I just hasten their arrival to her?
But that was a choice that you made for them. What about their choice?
The humans think they're in a better place now. Do they need a choice when we can just send them to where they ultimately are going? You could come back whenever you want, Alman.
Amina's going to stop for a second, put her head down, looking conflicted. And I think that's where she's going to pause for a moment. She doesn't know what to say.
At this point, I think that Amon would definitely, again, going with the superhero trope, this would be a DC movie smash through the ceiling.
Oh, gosh.
Landing in the center of this thing, you know, just not even, I mean, not even caring who's underneath me. Is somebody underneath me when I commit?
Draw a card.
It's the Three of Pentacles. Now, Pentacles is my suit. I'm not sure if that matters.
But you're not speaking, right?
No.
No. Oh, man. Let me... Who gets to be underneath Ammon as he lands?
Sorry.
Mina doesn't actually pause. She gets crushed by a piece of roof.
Well, I mean, it makes sense because Koi is jogging around. Amina's just standing there.
In the middle of the room.
Yeah, so it's between you and Yuri.
Yuri left.
Yuri stepped back to the door, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Did Yuri step
You're
back?
You're having a thoughtful conversation.
You it makes sense.
Mash.
Yeah, right. I feel like
this is I don't like know if this books. Is more Amon and Amina's relationship or your and my relationship, Phil. It's probably both.
Where is Jack standing?
Jack was getting out. Yeah. I did my one trick.
It makes sense. Yep. I'm sorry, Amina.
Do I need to draw for how bad this is going to be for me?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Oh no.
I mean, I could have worded it different. I could have come in through the front door, but no.
No.
No, no. Never.
Nope. That's no. not right. That was the That's problem. Not right.
It's the Ace of Cups.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. That is great. Let me see.
Cups is my suit if you care.
Oh.
Yours is striding, correct?
Speaking.
Speaking. I don't think you can speak your way.
I was talking at the time.
Fear not. Yes. So as Amon just completely comes bursting down through the roof, you know, this building was already very fragile and only held up because of Yuri's miracle, but now that this outside force has kind of blasted it to smithereens, coming down at 300 miles per hour, the whole building has just shuddered and is now collapsing. And so, Amon, you are able to just briefly kind of, you don't completely crush Amina as you come blasting down, but you definitely come down and knock her back, just send her like flying into the ground, you know, with all these beams and debris just falling down upon her. But you got to make your big entrance.
I definitely do.
Am I taking a wound for this?
No, you're able to just sort of, you know, soak it, as it were, just based on what you drew.
I'm just like hopping from rocks to rocks as they're falling down. I'm just kind of like, doot, doot, doot.
I mean, I probably don't even realize that I knocked her out of the way.
You completely don't.
Oh, of course I don't. But I would say, just as talking about our relationship between mine and Amina, I mean, I would consider myself probably more influential, perhaps. Better is another word for it, but more influential in guiding humanity than anybody else in this cohort that we have assembled, except perhaps maybe Amina. She has an interesting thing. So just in terms of our dynamic, just FYI. But of course, I don't realize that at all because I knocked her out of the way. I would land and probably assume my full height. I mean, again, probably, you know, tattered clothes from flying so fast. I mean, you know, it's super strong looking. I mean, it looks like Superman. I mean, come on now. My eye would be illuminated slightly, almost like a pale green, like an aquamarine, almost just in this rage. So I have been basically forced to, you know, hold back for, you know, the past little bit. And now Dantillina is going to feel my full power.
I want Amina to look up at Amonset, and I want to recall a memory for Amon, and look at it, and it's going to be a little bit interrupting your drama here. She's going to look up at him and just say, "Really? Again?"
What situation here does this happen before?
We have, she is going to recall a memory, ask you to recall a memory of, I owe you a favor because you helped me escape the House of Wisdom with a book on demons as the Mongols sacked Baghdad. And if you hadn't, the important knowledge contained within might have been lost forever. Now, if we're recalling this memory together, is this something that because the thing that would be remembered here is demon lore knowledge, is this something that he could remember because I triggered the memory, or is this something that I would have to remember?
So you are the one that has demon lore, correct?
Yes.
Go ahead.
He's gearing up to fight, and I was hoping maybe I could trigger for him something that he learned about demons because of helping me escape with this book.
I will let him draw with a blessing just once. But I need you to describe it a little bit further. What was in this book? How epic was it all?
So it was another instance. This book was something that I had been working on with the people there. We were compiling a lot of information. It was going to be a pretty major work, and then the Mongols came and threatened to just utterly destroy it as they started destroying the city. And Amon knew that I was there and somehow knew that I was in need, but instead of coming to find me like a normal person, he decided to come crashing in through the ceiling and in a very similar way, and nearly lost the book because of his showboating there.
Look, if Hulagu Khan had not been such, you know, a prissy boy about, you know, everything that was going on, I mean, we easily could have you know, scared him out of there, but whatever.
But the book itself was tracking the actions of several major demons up to that point, and sort of seeing the major events that they had been a part of, and then speculation on what their end goals might be, and also looking at ways in which they might have been thwarted in some of the things that they were doing.
Perfect.
Amin has selective memory, so he doesn't remember it anyway. Like, he just he thinks that, you know, he made a grand entrance and all that, but perhaps something could trigger here. Who knows?
Perhaps. What are you trying to do, Amin?
All right, so I mean, I think it's safe to say that I'm pretty pissed off right now, right? Because this person just threatened not only my brothers and sisters, my team. This is a threat to our continued good work in the development and of humanity, continuing the fine work that that we have done since Mom left. In fact, Yuri, you know, Mom leaving, that may have been a good thing, because that leaves us to be able to really bring out our skills and talents. So just FYI. But there's also a side layer. So one, there's the just rank, like, just how dare you, you know, like, come on now. And then there's the side of Cassie, which is bringing this passion, anger that I'm not as apt to deal with.
Sure. Real quick to Yuri, since Yuri seems to be very much into Mom and her decrees and the laws that govern angels more than everyone else in the group. Yeah. So Amin made a statement that maybe it was a good thing that Mom had left you all. And one of the first laws that the angels had sort of declared, you know, the older angels, you know, to help with one another in this, you know, just tumultuous, crazy time. And it was, thou shalt not make any compact between thyself and heaven. And, you know, it was written to respect the creator herself. And so any sort of word that is said against Mom, that is making someone play or impersonate God, is just a big no-no. And sometimes Amin kind of toes the line there.
I think that's definitely an old thing, and that Yuri's come around to, there's nothing in existence that is not a part of Mom's plan. Either everything is part of Mom's plan or nothing is part of Mom's plan.
Yeah.
So either way, there's no way to answer it. So Yuri doesn't worry about that. And Yuri really enjoys Amin said.
Perfect.
You know, it's nice to have somebody to talk to through the years, as Yuri continues to walk towards the door to leave the church.
It's lonely. And angels are not social creatures.
Nope.
No. All right, Amin. So
I have to draw with a blessing?
Yeah.
All right. The first one I have here is Michael, the Empress. Fertility. Oh, okay. And fruitfulness. Assures peace between married couples. So who knows what that means.
Back to Cassie.
That means new linen.
Ooh, here we go. And then we have the Five of Swords. Ichiel, the desire to know, the acquisition of wisdom.
Perfect. What was the first card? Sorry, what number?
The Empress.
Okay, so you have it. Okay. I have the Six of Cups. Hmm. And, wow, I'm just drawing. All right, Four of Swords. There you go. Yeah, so you are definitely able, so you're attacking or are you talking him to death?
Oh, I'm talking him. Because that's my skill, 100%.
Yeah. So there are a couple things within battle. Like, you could either attack them or you can attempt to, like, restrain them or take away, like, one of their advantages if you're choosing not to just deal damage. So, yeah, go ahead and describe what you do.
So I think that I would want to, if I was in this situation, either prevent their method of attack or prevent their method of escape. And so, but because my skills revolve around talking, I'm not going to attack straight on. I'm going to try to communicate in a way that I'm going to try to communicate with him in a way that gives other people the opportunity to have a method of advantage. So I've missed this whole conversation that's gone down, right?
Right.
So I'm going to come down and I'm just going to be like, tell me if you're so high and mighty, if you think of yourself as so high and mighty as most demons do, naturally. What do you even want? What do you want to happen here? Why are you in this place?
Amen. Fashionably late as ever.
I think I'm right on time. I say, yeah. With a sneer. There's definitely a sneer there.
He looks at you and he says, why would Mom use Starship? No, just kidding. Nobody does. Anyways. He looks over her and just shrugs his shoulders. He's like, have you never been bored? Amen.
Can't say that maybe, I have.
Maybe you haven't been around long enough, but there's only so many ways you can kill a person. I feel like I may have done them all. He sort of yawns and rolls his shoulders, but those humans that people care for, those ones, their deaths are so much more delicious. And you had one. Where'd you take her?
Oh, somewhere else. Not of your concern right now.
Oh, but it is, Hammond. It really is, because watching your face, if she were to die, now that might get rid of some of my boredom, but.
Oh no. Dantillion is psychopath confirmed.
But as I said, I'm bored. I'm done. Seems like all your friends are running away. Just leaving you here, though.
Perhaps we can find a solution for your boredom. Let's make a deal.
Yes?
If I defeat you, you'll leave all of us alone, including all those we care about.
I'll be a little bit more specific, Amen. Aren't you supposed to be good at making deals?
If I win, you'll leave this I guess I can't say existence. plane, are there multiple planes? Can we talk in that realm? Can we, you'll leave, or you will sequester yourself in your relic for a millennia.
And what are you defining as when? And what happens if I were to win?
If you were to win, you will be free to enjoy yourself in any way you see fit. Not saying that we'll not try to stop you, but we'll give you a head start.
Oh, Ammon, I really do not understand how you've been so successful, as the humans say. That is a horrible deal. Am I not already free to do as I please? I mean, I could leave here right now and follow the scent to that pleasant little human of yours, but I do believe.
So, oh, you wouldn't want to do that.
No?
No, you know why?
Hmm.
Because you don't care about the human. You care about the reaction that you get. You care about the enjoyment that you receive from watching people suffer. So let me give this to you. If you win,
again, what is winning? That is such a human concept. And I believe you've been around them much, much too long, Ammon. Ironheart.
That's true. I'm at a loss here, boys.
Ironheart. How?
And ladies.
How does this make you feel, my dear brother, sister, whatever guise it is that you've taken on?
He steps forward. His sword is still pulling the heat to it. He has not released that as of yet. If anything, it might be burning a little bit hotter because he is infuriated with the idea that this demon would even be allowed to leave this room. And he steps towards the demon, his target, the thing he knows he is here to kill, the reason he is bred on Earth. And with a quick and swift action, he will once again bring his sword down.
Wait!
As he does, he will round on Amonsette, though, because he is the one. He doesn't strike Amonsette, but he is definitely pissed.
Dun, dun, dun!
I'm over here being full Secretary of State, and you're over there being like, you know, full war criminal. Here we go.
Yeah, pretty much.
Who is still within this building? Boom, I mean, Yuri and Jack have just, they're just kind of having a drink outside, like, making bets who's going to come out.
I can be back in there if I need to.
You can.
Amina is standing just off to the side of Amonsette.
But Jack, you still have that feeling. It's nagging at you, eating at you. One of these people is going to take something from you. Is it your relic? You can't tell.
Still have that, right? You've
checked it multiple times. It's still there. It's still there. It's still there. But why would your siblings want to do this to you? You just
Jack, no, don't do it.
Have tried to help them. and they keep trying to take something from you. Oh. All right. What, Ironheart, you're attacking Amon?
No, I attack the demon, but I round on Amon because he just voluntarily offered this demon an escape. This demon that I have been told that I know of has done these evil things. He will not live if I have any say in it.
Yeah, let's see if you do have a say in it. Can you draw two cards for me?
Okay. First card is the Five of Swords, which is my suit, and I am striking.
Is that Keanu Reeves?
Then my second, oh, this is really nice, the Knight of Swords.
Mm. Yes, Boosh. But this is not for you.
Oh.
I drew the Magician.
Oh, no.
As well as the Seven of Swords. Ironheart, you have just been completely blinded by this anger. And as you look at Dandelion, you sort of see this dark red haze go around his side where his pocket is. And you notice that for a moment, but then the next moment, everyone else is your enemy. Amon tried to let this demon get away. Koi loved a demon. Amina, she has some part to play in this, you're certain of that. But just over and over in your mind, you keep hearing that Dandelion is your friend. He is your brother. It is them that are doing this to you. It is them that are evil. They have turned away from Mother, and they are the ones that are trying to destroy humanity and thwart your mission.
Okay. So yeah, he rounds on his siblings, his sword drawn, the heat pulsating from it, and kind of places himself in a protective position between them and Dandelion. And he, I would say that the room is starting to light on fire again just from the pure heat of his sword. And he'll attack his siblings at this point, condemning them for the things that they have done, how they are willing to let demons run free in this world to wreak havoc on the children of our mother. How you could fall in love with such a thing and still call yourself an angel, say you are here to protect, and how you could work with a demon. None of these things are of Mother's plan. None of these things are what we should be doing.
Amina is going, as soon as she sees that Ironheart is beginning to strike out at us, Amina is going to step forward and speak in a loud, unnaturally booming voice, and with the voice of God say to Ironheart, you are betraying your purpose of slaying demon.
What does the voice of God do?
The voice of God, as long as I don't lie, which I didn't, the person that I speak to, anyone who hears it, believes absolutely that what I say is true.
Okay, so Dealer, how does this affect Ironheart? Does he snap out of it?
What were your exact words there, Amina?
Said you have
betrayed... Say carefully. Say very generically everything that you say.
Amina's talking now.
I said, you have betrayed your true purpose to slay the demon.
So, Ironheart, you have betrayed your true purpose to slay the demon. Who you believe are demons right now are still alive.
So I still believe that my siblings are demons, correct?
Yes.
I strike.
That is what you believe.
I will strike at them.
All right.
Sorry, guys.
I gave you a second chance.
I wasn't gonna.
Yuri, could you do me a favor?
Depends.
Could you look up a woman by the name of Jenna Horowitz and tell me if she's okay right now? Because this conversation has me a little concerned, and I gotta go do a thing. So I'll be right back. And I'm gonna
focus on Jack.
The counselor or the legal intern? The school counselor or the legal intern? And you're gone.
Yeah, she's neither. She's a poker player that I like because she's almost good enough. And then I'm back in the building, and I am going to try to wrap my arms around Ironheart from behind with a nice little lump in between us.
Wait, didn't I explode that already?
I exploded the one I had earlier.
You got another one?
You don't know that I didn't. More specifically, Ironheart doesn't necessarily know that I didn't.
I would have never expected Jack to give so many hugs tonight.
This is, I know.
Who
are you, Jack? But Jack, this person's trying to take something from you.
I know, and something I need to stop all of this right now. Do I have to draw any cards or anything to grab Ironheart in a bluffing landmine hug?
Yes.
How many cards do you want to see? I got the Ace of Wands.
Ooh.
That's true. I'm trying to think if this should be a complex test or not. No, because I love it. Go ahead.
So, yeah, I've got what may or may not be a landmine in between me and Ironheart. And I just, grab hold of Ironheart and say, all right, guys, I've been having this nagging feeling the whole time, and I'm just going to come clean because I don't want to be the guy who hides a zombie bite. And I have this feeling that one of you is trying to take something from me. Probably Ironheart, judging by the way that Ironheart is acting right in this exact moment. But you're all suspect, and that's weird. I think it might be Danny's fault. So,
so when he yells this out, I would immediately say it is, it is, it is the art of communion. Dantillion must be of Gabriel's. Or one of Gabriel's adherents. He has the art of sending messages and sharing sensations. So he may be able to make you think or feel whatever he wants you to feel.
He has the power to do that.
So is that what's happening, Danny? Ooh, is this your is this your game? You're making me feel things? Giving me the feels.
Oh, he's
Am I making you
feels.
Feel things, Jack?
I'm calling. Tell me, is this you? Also, is this your chip? Are you going to still kill everybody, or can I let you go now? Ironheart,
you still want to kill everyone.
Do I see Jack as a threat? Or is it only the three that was initially in there?
Go ahead and draw again. blighted since you are already under control.
Okay.
But Jack is giving her or him a hug.
Okay, this is going to be fun. Sam, you're going to love me. The first card I drew was the King of Coins.
Okay.
Okay, okay, yeah.
The second card I drew was the Devil.
Oh my God. Oh my mom, what is happening?
Oh my mom.
Dude, that's dad, oh my right? My dad.
Yeah, have fun with that one, dealer.
Yes.
The Devil is just one of us.
Yeah, no one actually knows who Lucifer is, right? Human construct, right, Yuri?
No. He's a nice guy. I miss him.
I think I read in here that they don't actually, no, many people have claimed to be Lucifer over the time.
Yeah, I hear he's taking a vacation in LA right now.
Got a new girlfriend?
Recording a television show or something like that?
Right. I mean, Tom Holland is a great cover.
Fair.
Demons get bored very easily.
Yeah.
I haven't noticed. Oh, Ironheart. Oh, Jack. Let me come back to you. Koi, what you doing?
I've been jogging this whole time trying to clear my head, and it is not working because
sob running.
Yeah, my sogging, sobbing, I don't know.
Sobbing.
Finally to the point where I would say this is probably after Amonsette crashes through the building. Somewhere in here, I think maybe like during the hug, the second death hug, somewhere in that activity, I just come to a stop and my legs are like, for the first time ever, my legs are like jello. Like my knees are buckling and I'm wobbly and I'm just watching this exchange of Ironheart now trying to kill us. But then now knowing the truth of what Dantillion said to Yuri, I'm now looking at Dantillion just kind of in bewilderment. And so while they're doing whatever they're doing over there with the death hug, I'm gonna come around the other side. And so I heard what you said. It's, were you speaking the truth?
No, you can't lie to Yuri.
It just doesn't make sense. Why would it be true and then you go and do all this destruction and go against what I desire? Why would you do that to me if you cared?
He's silent for a moment. Again, the death hug going on beyond you guys. But it just seems like the moment has just frozen on you two. You know, there's just so much happening right now. But he looks at you again, just exactly as you remember millennia ago, you know, the beginning of humanity. And he just shakes his head. Even demons have things that we have to do, Koi.
You were willing to throw it all away for something you had to do?
They're not things that you have to do.
I've always had things to do. I've been doing things for millennia. And for what? What's the point of doing it all if there isn't anyone by your side to share it with? what's the point? Why are you doing this?
That's just it, Koi. There is no point to any of this. We are just mom's playthings, and I got tired of playing her game, and you're still in it. Even though you've been running, you haven't been able to escape that thought.
This was not, we're not playing. We were not playing. It was real, okay? It was real, and you just threw it all away because you got bored. You got bored? That's your excuse? You got bored? Really? That's your excuse? I can't believe you. I can't believe it. I've been so angry for so long, and you come in here and you tell Yuri what I've been wanting to hear for so long. You just come in here and tell Yuri because you can lie to Yuri, but you've lied to me for all these years. What is wrong with you?
Wait, have you even been trying to find me? You've been running for years, pretending to all your friends that you are just some airheaded, gotta take care of the leopards person. You are the one that is trying to hide the true power that you have. You could be so much more, and yet you are on mother's errand, not realizing your full potential.
My full potential. You saw my full potential, but that extinguished years ago. That was the choice you made, if you want me to quote our friend Yuri, our brother. You made that choice. I choose to follow my path, which is what mother set out for me. And maybe it does include running, but it doesn't include not being who I am, which is what you've been hiding for years.
I'm just trying to have you realize everything that you can be, Koi. What have you done for mother? What have you done for humanity that they haven't just thrown back into your face or killed or destroyed? That's all humanity ever was and ever was going to be. Do you think I had to push them that hard? No, it's human nature. We created humans, remember, Koi? Angels created humans.
Yes, and they were beautiful, and so were we, until you poisoned them.
Leave what you want, Koi. But if you want to join me, I would welcome you.
What do you have to offer me that mother and my siblings don't?
Mother has nothing to offer you. She shuts you out.
This is her will. I'm just doing what I was meant to do here.
Do you honestly believe that this is her will? That you are to suffer like this? That all of your siblings are to suffer like this? Do you think that's her will?
I think I can rightfully say that I had not suffered until I had met you and we spent that time together. Mm-hmm. That's my suffering. Thank you. Thank you for that.
Do you feel more powerful for it?
I feel more confused, especially after what you told Yuri. I don't know what's right anymore. That's why I run. I run to find the answers. And somehow it led me here to you.
Then maybe that's, as you put it, mother's sign that you should be with me.
Damn.
He takes a step forward towards you, closing the distance. And he holds out his hand. Koi, just come be with me. Anything that you've done with these siblings of ours has put you into danger. You can do so much more with me.
How am I to trust you? How am I to know that you're not just going to leave me again? these siblings have never left me. You did.
Where's Yuri right now? What's Ironheart doing right now, Jack?
Ironheart is under your control.
Do you think it would take that much? He doesn't trust you anymore. He knows that we've been together. He'll never see you as a sibling.
You always see the worst in everyone.
Maybe I just see the truth in everyone. Come on, Koi. Koi.
I need to go for a run. Koi takes off.
Ooh, that was intense. Oh, man.
Could we hear that?
Yeah.
I was standing right there watching with my eye.
But I mean, Jack has Ironheart and an explosive hug. Amon is at Ironheart's sword?
Correct.
Yes. No. Amina is just kind of frozen. Amina, how are you doing, babe?
Amina has been listening to the conversation going on, and has pulled out around her neck on a fairly rough hemp necklace. There is at the end of it tied a small clay jar with a small stopper in it, and she has pulled it out and is staring at it as she listens to the conversation between Dantillion and Koi.
What is this necklace, Amina?
The necklace is it's a lacrimarium, a tear jar used in burials. Typically, they're left in the tombs of the people who are being buried, but the person that that died had no tomb because of the volcano. There was no time to bury anyone. And so this is a jar that she carries so that it's a reminder to her of those people, but specifically of Lysagoras, that was the special individual to her back on the island. And so she's contemplating the idea of suffering, but also contemplating the idea of choice. And whether or not so much of the suffering that she has endured, especially at the hands of Dantillion, has been her choice. And whether or not she wants to let go of the suffering and relinquish the power that Dantillion has over her.
All the deep thoughts. Okay.
While flaming sword.
And back over to the flaming sword. Is it a mine? Is it not a mine? Where did Jack go in that split second that he disappeared talking about Janice?
Jenna.
Is she okay? It's human. All right. But Ironheart drew the devil.
Oh no.
So, Ironheart, you have two choices. You may either get Yuri off of you by force, or you can Jack. Yuri's vaping outside. or you could go
blueberry
ahead and strike Amon.
Is Jax holding me, impeding me from destroying the demons?
If you want to risk separating us and having what might be a landmine go off, no.
Do you feel lucky?
Ironheart, are you even thinking clearly?
That's true. And I do see Jack as a threat.
Yeah.
I see everyone in this room pretty much as a threat at this point.
They're all threats.
So I'll outright ask in your ear, do you think you can survive another landmine going off at this close range?
wrong thing to say. He'll hear these words and a smile will come fully across his face.
Oh, no.
And he will push Jack back, knowing that they had all been hit by a landmine previously, and pretty much assuming that most to all of them cannot survive.
Since you want to kill everyone.
I do! So if it takes my life to come on, kill all the demons.
I've got like a dilemma here about whether or not to go, and you're about to kill us.
Yeah, pretty much. So he'll laugh and he'll throw Jack back as he goes, then we all die.
And the thing that's definitely not a landmine will thud harmlessly to the floor.
Womp womp.
Whoops. Jack, what do you do?
Okay, so you called my bluff. Well done.
Okay, so at this point, can I clap my hands and yes. get Ironheart's attention?
I don't know. He's pissed that this landmine is not a
thing. What are you doing? Are you like Garcon? Garcon?
Yeah.
I don't know, dealer. I don't know if he would, because he's turned on Jack. He's pissed.
Can I get his attention in any way?
Use Ironheart,
I thought the demon was the one trying to commit suicide here. What are you doing? No, so seriously, what demons. Are you doing?
Can Yuri interject one sentence?
Yes, please.
Which would be acting like a demon.
Oh my gosh. Not helpful, Yuri. Not helpful.
I mean, you guys are creating, this is interesting now.
All right. I would like to somehow get Ironheart's attention and lock eyes with him.
Figure out how to get his attention.
I would like to throw something at his face.
That's going to get his sword's attention.
I would like to pick up a piece of the pew that is next to me.
Amon said you have all this rubble that you brought to the ground.
You got debris, man.
Debris that you
created. I'd like to get this debris that was totally caused by the landmine and not by me.
You should pick up a hymnal and throw that.
Okay. I would like to pick up the hymnal. It falls open to hymn number 146, Be Thou My Vision. And I throw that at I throw that at Ironheart. And does this
think that means you're under arrest? He threw the book at you.
They're attacking you, Ironheart.
I know. Is
not very well.
What is number 146? I do not know.
Oh my gosh, please.
Rejoice, the Lord is King.
It could be Christmas.
Oh wait, theme. You guys were supposed to sing.
Sorry, it's I Worship You, Almighty God.
I worship you.
This is the celebration hymn. I could go get one of the other ones from my garage. I have about 40 of them.
I obviously used the Reformed version, not that silly Baptist Denver Seminary version, whatever you got there.
This one is a Baptist one, actually.
I knew it.
Hollywood Baptist Church.
Not
thank
true
you.
Presbyterian, whatever. It's
fine. Shout out.
Hashtag Reformed theology. Okay, so at this point, I would have thrown this at you, but I It doesn't actually make a like a, it doesn't actually hit you like in the face, right? Because I mean, I speak at seminars. I don't actually throw things. So it would probably like hit you in the side. It wouldn't feel very threatening.
Well, that's for Ironheart to decide.
All right, listen.
I threw a book at you non-threateningly.
Yes. I just kind of tossed it kind of with an upward hand.
A little lob, yeah.
Lob.
Ironheart, read this.
So would I have turned my back to Amonsett before he threw it?
That is up to you. Is Jack now the person that you are trying to attack?
Yes.
Then yes.
Okay, so this book hits me kind of in my back.
Side.
Side-ish? Okay.
Backside. The backside.
I aimed for the obliques.
Ooh.
Quite large.
Dang.
So Jack just had this failed landmine that did not kill everyone like you had been planning.
Yes,
but
I know.
Amon is back behind you and has... Is this the second time that he's attacked you?
Just grazed. It wasn't a toss.
Chucked a book at you.
It was very soft. It landed pages first.
Gave you a paper cut, maybe?
No.
How clearly is Ironheart able to remember his siblings? Like, obviously he sees them as a threat.
Mm-hmm.
But is he able to remember that Amonsett protected Cassie?
But did he protect Cassie to use for his own devices later on? Did he actually protect her? He took her somewhere that you do not know. You could have these memories in your mind, but it's sort of like static on a radio.
Why did you draw death? Terrible.
I drew the devil and death in the same night. You know, this
is
like great.
Ironheart drew the devil. If Yuri had done that, this would be completely different.
We would be stuck in a philosophical like landmine.
Oh no.
You'd in all the your internet.
I just want to make eye contact with
He is going to turn on Amonsett. He is going to give in to the notion that Amonsett is actually a threat to Cassie.
Oh, solid. Okay.
So he will turn from Jack and try to strike at Amonsett.
But
are you able to meet his eyes when he is coming at you with a flaming sword for 10 seconds? He's right there.
No, I'm not. No. So, but as I would see him jump, I would probably jump into the air, right, to avoid this onslaught.
You gonna break through the ceiling again?
No.
There's already a hole.
Okay.
No.
There'll be another hole.
No.
Fine. Beside the hole.
This is kind of like a beautiful, like, you know, layout pike position, you know, jump into the air, feet together, of course, just kind of going prone against the ceiling.
Let's see here.
I'm just picturing this. This just looks ridiculous to me.
And what did I say last time when we decided to come here? We will likely cause more chaos than any demon.
And then as you do that weird pike jump, Koi's just gonna...
Perfect 10 pike
just,
jump.
Just run underneath your legs, like, in distress. About...
Okay, it's fine.
Koi, okay.
Do I have to draw anything?
Yuri's outside vaping. Let's just throw this all
in. Set the scene here.
Set the scene. So you have this white picturesque sort of steeple that, you know, is surrounded by all these buildings, and you see Yuri outside just vaping. It seems like all is calm. And then inside the building, you have Jack with like this hymnal that had just fallen out of his shirt on the ground at his feet. He's just staring at it, being like, how did I not get lucky? You have Koi just like running in circles in distress, just like shaking their head. They're just like periodically falling to the ground, doing some push-ups, getting back up, running, doing some burpees. And then you have Amina like standing in the corner looking at this necklace of tears and just silent at all of this. You have Dantillion standing, you know, basically where the podium used to be, just like all smug as can be, watching Koi every so often, his eyes just sort of glancing over to them. And then you have Ironheart charging with a sword, and then you have Amon just kind of going whoop onto the
ceiling. Yep, that's exactly what happened.
This is what is happening right now.
That's a circus.
Yeah. Uriel, like, all according to plan.
Mom has a sense of humor.
She does.
You better.
So I jump up in the air. Does that involve a test?
No, you have the wings of Nesher. You're fine. Certainly do. I mean, if you are trying to softly jump up and not break the ceiling again.
Or... No, I mean, I don't care. I mean, come on. Okay. I already made a lot, you know, so I just jump in. I mean, but it is beautiful pike position. I mean, let's be honest.
Okay. Everything. Right.
Naturally. Yeah. Everything I do is great.
Mm-hmm.
Always. 100% of the time.
Perfect. So your prey has jumped up, but there's still...
Has he jumped high enough, though? Because I have a Viking longsword.
Oh, boy.
How long and is
it
your...
It currently is an additional foot long of flames.
So how long is it?
Oh.
That's a rather personal question.
Size doesn't matter.
In this case, it kind of does.
It kind of does.
That's
what Koi's thinking about as Koi's
so
distress.
The size of a Koi. Viking longsword that I just pulled up is 39 inches.
I need to know the typical height of a church. Well.
I think you're fine. I mean, if I'm
somewhere above 39 inches, usually.
Yes.
26
it,
feet?
No, it yeah. has to be above
24?
40. No, 51 inches.
I didn't know close. I'd be doing math today.
Pretty close.
I know, God.
Yeah, that's not one of my attributes.
So then we need to ask, how tall is Ironheart and what types of arms does she have? Yes. Are they normal size or longer?
Right. I mean, he's taken on the form of a fairly tall gentleman that could wear a 39 inch sword, because that's not small. That's over 3 feet.
She really wants to get a slash at him before.
I think you're about to just get slashed.
No. I jump high enough.
I mean,
draw a card.
Yeah, it's like one of us.
Both of you. What
is that?
I drew Rochelle, the King of Cups, God seeing everything.
The Ten of Staves.
All right, Amon, you're able to jump up high enough.
I knew it. Easy peasy.
And fast enough. But your prey has escaped you for now.
Okay. So he will round back on Jack if this flying thing is not a threat to him at this point.
Then the guy prone on the ground is a threat to you?
You stop me from killing everyone, yes.
How far are you gonna fall?
Yeah, he will turn on, because Koi is God only knows where. Yeah, you're the next closest target.
So I think there was a request for
Yeah.
Amina.
Mm-hmm. I'm fine letting them fight if they want.
Well, I mean, you had a window Koi. There where Dantillion yeah. wasn't engaged.
No, Dantillion's watching. I mean, Koi had a conversation while they were fighting. Now, Amina. All right. Real quick, so you could get to an epic spot that I can pan away from. So you're stalking over to Jack.
Correct.
Jack, you're prone on the ground.
I got knocked back away from Ironheart, so.
You're looking up at your brother.
Yep. Hmm.
Ironheart, what you doing?
A poker face.
Yeah. I am bringing my sword down to strike. You stand with the demons. You want to protect them. You want them to live. You have no right to live.
You clearly are out of your mind. I blew up a demon. You were there. You set the mine off. You're the one swinging a sword at your brother. Who's the demon now?
I kill any that stand with the damned.
Then kill yourself.
He will strike. He is not in a right mind at this point. Like, he will strike at Jack.
And that's where we sink cut?
Yep.
Nice.
Amina.
So Amina is staring down at her lacrimorium and begins walking forward. And walking directly to Dantillion. She begins to speak once she gets close to him. She begins to speak and says, "It really is all about choice. The choice that you have made to watch the suffering of others, the choice that we have made to try and endure it alongside them. We choose the suffering that gives you life." And she looks up at him and she says, "For all these years, I gave you that power out of choice. And I choose now to give it to you no longer." And she breaks the necklace from around her neck and holds it out to Dantillion. And she says, "These were tears cried for the island of Akrotiri. They were tears cried for Lysagoras. And now they are allowing me to be free from the sorrow that I chose." And if Koi is nearby, she turns to Koi and says, "Koi, whatever you choose to do, know that the sorrow or the joy, it's all up to you. But this one, this Dantillion, he would have you choose sorrow just so that he can watch." And she says to Dantillion, turns back and says, "So enjoy this sorrow while it lasts." And she takes the necklace and she throws it at his feet, and the lacrimorium made of clay shatters at his feet. And she looks him in the eyes and says, "I do hope that it was all worth it." And she turns around and begins to walk for the door.
You feel better now, Amina?
Without turning around, she says, I don't think I've felt this good in over 2 millennia. And she just keeps walking.
So have I made you stronger? He calls after you.
She pauses and she turns with a very wry smile and says, no, it's the absence of you that now makes me stronger. And she leaves. If he says anything more, she doesn't listen, she doesn't hear, but she walks with a step that is lighter than probably anyone in the room has ever seen her with. She appears that she has no longer the age that she appears.
Aww. Side note. Were your tears in that lacrimorium? How do you say that?
They might have been. Usually it's more of a oil or spice mix. Okay. But I think that she may have actually had tears that had gone in there because she didn't need the oil to be in there. She had nothing to bury, so she was carrying around sorrow. I think there might have been some of her tears shed in there.
So this is something that is unique to relics, but if you angels don't give like their blood or like fluid samples sort of haphazardly, because any piece of an angel is power. So even, you know, the liquid from your tears is something that can be sort of used against you. Like, because angels don't shed skin cells or hair, you know, like human beings. Like, sometimes it could, like, come off, but...
Then no, definitely no tears in
there. I was going to say, Can Koi get it?
Just kind of drops and like picks
against
up
all. Well, I was just thinking, you know, Koi's never seen Amina like that.
Oh, so are you going to use another angel's power?
It's just very inspiring, especially what Amina said, that I have a choice and I would be suffering. I've never seen Amina like that.
Why don't you take her power?
Do I have to draw for that, or does it take it?
No, Dan Chilling, well, if you walk over there to pick up the pieces of Amina's, you know, part of her angelic presence, he'll let you. Go ahead, Koi. Take it.
I want the strength that she has.
Sort of holds out his hands. So it's there for you. You can have it.
All right, I'm going to take it.
Yeah, so you sort of pick up these clay shards, and would you say, do you want to recant and say that there weren't tears then, or do we want to keep that?
No, I'll say that there was, I'll say that she had left one tear in there, knowing how precious that was, that
tear.
Substance was, yeah, single tear in a jar.
Yeah.
That had been in there.
So yeah, you drop to your knees on the ground and you pick up this clay shard and you find one that still sort of has that tear kind of pulled into, you know, like the curvature of it, and you pick it up and do you drink that tear?
Mm. Can I do it like a little cologne, like a little dab dab?
Put it right here.
Yeah.
You know, I angels can absorb it that way. Yeah.
Yeah, our signs.
Yeah. So you place this tear upon your skin and sort of feel this bolt of lightning go through you, and it feels slightly off, like dirty in a way. You've taken something that you're not supposed to, but it also feels very good.
Do I feel anything?
Do. Somebody has a piece of you. Something's missing. You almost feel dismembered in a way, even though it's this tear, but you recognize it as something. Maybe this was something that had escaped your memory, that this was so important, you know, and this sort of I'm getting rid of this, that I have the choice, you know, like it just sort of escaped you, but now it's coming back as you have this feeling that something's not right.
I want to turn around and look. Is it obvious to me that Koi is the one who took it?
Yeah.
Then I want to look directly at Koi and shout from, because I'm almost to the door now, and shout from across the way. It's okay, Koi. Use it well. And then I wanna leave and sort out how I'm feeling.
Koi's gonna turn to Dantillion and say, that is true love, is the giving, not the taking away.
But you can control her now.
No. I'm not doing this the way that you do. I am using it to be wiser. Amina is so brilliant. And you were right. I've been running away, and now I need to use my smarts, and I can't go with you. As much as I thought about it, I've been running around here while my siblings are trying to chop each other to bits. I've been thinking about it, and I can't.
As you say those last words, he grabs you and just kisses you. And back over to Choppy Chops. So, I am going to have you both pull two cards. I will pull some cards too. And go ahead and reveal the first card.
Two of Swords.
What is that? World. The World. So, you're able to break out of it as you sort of bring this sword down on your brother. The sword embeds into his shoulder as you sort of move it away, like last second. You jerk over because you finally, you're not able to stop yourself fully from bringing the blade down on him, but at least you're able to make it so that you do not outright kill him as you sort of embed it into his shoulder. And that seems to knock you to your senses just enough to to come to yourself and realize what's been going on. You're muted. Sorry, the world is always a dramatic success.
Yes, that is a very good thing.
Finally.
So, realizing what he has done and that he has been protecting a demon, he will turn and round on the demon and charge.
Ow.
Yeah, he'll apologize for that later.
Good role play. Good role play. Right there.
He's not happy that this demon was able to influence him in such a way. So he is rounding on the demon and attempting to end it.
Okay, 1 point of wound on you, Jack.
Okay.
But as you round on the demon has Koi wrapped up in this embrace and is just kissing them. Passionately.
Is there a landmine?
I think he's just happy to see him.
Yeah. That's no landmine.
So Ironheart will hesitate seeing this, kind of questioning Koi for a moment. But he will yell, Koi, run. And then he will go to strike.
So, Koi, it just feels like so much emotion was put into this, and he pulls back and looks at you and asks, are you going to run?
Make the bold choice.
Ma?
Ma doesn't talk to you anymore, remember? She left you.
You always know how to pull me back, don't you?
It's because you want to be back.
No,
Koi. Stay.
As soon as Koi is far enough away, even if it's just a step back from him, Ironheart strikes.
Koi, take a step back?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's pull two cards. You do lose your second card.
Okay.
All right. So you're pulling with me, and we are going to go ahead and play some 21.
Play some blackjack.
Yeah. Okay.
Some blackjack. All right.
Jack, did you invent blackjack? I know you invented poker, but blackjack, sure. You?
Yes.
He gave you an eyebrow wiggle. I think he did.
Oh, I couldn't see it. Okay, I have to zoom in. There we go.
Oh, it was double good.
There. Oh, now it's pronounced. Got it. Everybody on Twitch, you need to see. The eyebrow wiggle is real.
Eyebrow wiggle game. All right. So two cards, Ironheart.
Okay. So I got the Queen of Staves.
Okay, yeah.
And I got the Wheel of Fortune.
Oh!
Not your signifier.
Nope.
It's not your signifier.
But is Major Arcana treated as an ace? Isn't that 21?
Let's see here. Major Arcana is treated as an ace. 10 or 1? 11 or 1? 11, sorry.
11 or 1. I will take the 11 because that puts me at 21.
Here we go. Here we go. Major Arcana, Faith. We're going with 10.
10?
Yeah.
I've got 20. I'll take that.
All right. Page, yeah. Knight, Queen, King, 10. 2 to 10 face value. Ace is a 1 or 11, which is which card is an ace?
I dropped my card. I'm sorry.
There is an ace.
There is an ace. Okay.
Yeah, thanks. There is an ace up. Yeah.
I all right, know so you're 20.
Yep.
All right, so 5, right?
Mm-hmm. Koi is just like sweating 7. Over here.
7. So you're at what, 13?
3.
16.
3, 16. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
2.
18.
2, 18.
Nice. Yeah. Koi's sweating bullets.
That's a 9.
4. Or it's, oh, that's, yeah, it is 9.
9.
You bust.
That's a bust.
The bust.
Bust.
Oh my gosh.
You strike him.
I think literally.
That was a lot of cards.
You put up a fight. You were energized by our kiss.
Yuri, are you still vaping outside?
Yeah, my work here is done. I said there's an emotion and I left. There's an emotional catharsis room.
I can't talk. I'm in a beautiful mid-pike backflip this entire time. I mean,
just watching.
Just yeah. watching. Just kind of gazing down.
He what did a freaking miracle. I think he's off the hook to do yeah. too much more this round.
It's a good point. It's a good point.
It's true. Yeah, Ironheart, describe this.
As soon as I see Koi step back and realize that she is turning from the demon, I will bring my sword between them, making sure to separate them from one another. As the flames kind of trail behind, I cut across him. And with this, he will ignite on fire from the pure temperature of my sword. And it is up to you, dealer, what the cut does. Does it go through?
Damn right it's up. No.
Nice.
Yeah, so you bring your sword sort of across his chest. The knowledge of Koi and Dantillion kind of stilling your blade just slightly, but the entire time this is happening, Dantillion is just staring straight at Koi. His eyes never leaving as all of a sudden flames just sort of overtake him, you know, enveloping his entire body. Do you continue on, Ironheart?
I do.
All right.
My intention is to kill him.
Okay. One more game of blackjack.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
I think Koi is sob jogging again.
I'm done. No, you have to.
Block. I know you're like, look me in the eyes.
Oh, hey.
All right, we got a is that the same card?
Yes.
Wow. Twinning. Dang, this is the matching.
Yeah,
no.
4 to 4.
Entry. Okay.
What's your next one?
Sushi, okay. Go.
I'm thinking, sure we have the right.
That's a 10.
No, mine is a 14.
Uh-huh. 14, yeah.
If you look at the top of it, it should have another name on it.
It's Temperance. Yeah,
it's Temperance. Major Arcana.
Major Arcana.
So it'll be a 10, and yours is a 7.
Mm-hmm.
So we have, what, 14 to 11?
Yep.
Do you want to keep going?
I don't know.
Do it.
Well, I have to hit anyways. So, this is perfect.
Oh,
wait,
no.
Wait. Technically, she has to hit first.
It's true. I'll show you in a second.
And I will.
If you choose.
That's true. But I will bust. I got the 13 of cups.
What was that?
That is an major. 8.
It is major, so I bust.
Well, that's an 8. There should be no 13.
Oh, that's true. That's an ace. So
you still get 22.
It's an 8.
Yeah, an yes. 8 of cups. Sorry, 8. 8. So that is...
Isn't that
I
perfect?
Can do this. 14. Yeah, I bust. 20. I got 22.
What is this? What is this?
What's your card? By what the lovers.
The lovers! Oh my gosh! Oh my mom! Oh my mom! It you is, are not making this easy, Dante. What is happening?
But that's a 10, so y'all both bust, right?
Yep. No,
didn't she have...
I had 11.
Oh, 11. That does give me 21.
Yeah.
The lovers. The caca, you tried to be tried to be that crow, Ironheart. No, no, nay, nay.
No, no. Yeah, so the building just completely, finally collapses down. You know, you're able to see the night sky above you guys, and Dantillion is gone. Full retreat. Ironheart, once again.
And what?
Just a couple days time, you have failed to kill a demon.
Twice. Ironheart is enraged at this point.
Well, to keep it together.
Oh no. Knight of Coins?
All right. You can barely keep it together.
He lashes out with his sword at a rock or a pew, something that is solid, and watches his sword like cut through it. He doesn't look at his siblings, and he kind of storms off in the other direction.
Makes sense. All right. So Yuri, the building has collapsed down. You can see everyone again. You know? You and Amina have just sort of
put away my vape pen and say, "Are we done?"
Hey, did you find out about Jenna?
Yeah, she's fine. She just posted a YouTube video. Yeah.
Yeah. So, does anyone have one more thing that they're gonna say? One epic thing.
So, shawarma?
Shawarma.
Denny's?
Denny's? And then we just jump.
Yeah. But, Jack, you still feel that someone in this group.
It's probably Koi. She took something from you. She took Amina's tears, no problem. It's probably Koi.
Listen. Amina gave it to me. Amina said it's okay. I'm gonna walk over to Amina. Thank you.
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and leave it there. But yeah, that nagging feeling, Jack, has not left you. It's grown stronger. And with it, seems like whoever is wanting to take something from you is willing to do whatever it takes. Maybe even harm you to take it.
Huh.
Yep. All right, guys. So, thanks again for watching our session of Relics, a Game of Angels. Our players were Ashley as Ironheart. You can catch her here tomorrow night in our Scion campaign. Eric as Yuri. Phil as Amon Set, Paul as Amina the Professor, Danny as One-Eyed Jack, and Rowena as Koi Boomba. And I have been your GM, Sam. You can catch me here on Alternating Mondays and Star Wars with Alex Roth and Static Dawn, which will be switching to Saturdays in October with Spence Spencer. Huge thanks to Ian James for directing our stream. And as always, thanks for watching our video. Go ahead and give us a subscribe. Check out our Patreon at patreon.com/pennyforatale. I think that's how it is. And I'm sorry if I've gotten that wrong. And as always, thanks and have a good night.
Bye.
And don't know where Ian is right now.
He can't.